Now, we come in this chapter here to verse 51, and here is something that a great many people raise questions about, especially the skeptic today. Verse 51 reads, "Speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, when ye are passed over Jordan into the land of Canaan, then ye shall drive out all the inhabitants of the land from before you, and destroy all their pictures, and destroy all their molten images, and quite pluck down all their high places, and ye shall dispossess the inhabitants of the land, and dwell therein, for I have given you the land to possess it." Now, somebody's going to say, well, that's very cruel, I think, for the Lord to tell these people who we've seen have been rather disobedient and put them in the land, and there were such lovely people living in that land. They were nice, quiet neighbors, and they were very sweet folk. And why in the world would the Lord want to put them out of the land? Well, friends, that's the way the liberals been talking for years. And he gets all wrought up that the Lord put them out of the land. And the chances are every liberal today is living on a piece of ground that once belonged to the Indians. And when the liberals start giving back their property to the Indians, then I'm going to listen to them when they talk about the Old Testament. Now, will you look at this with me for just a moment? After all, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and those that dwell therein. This is his earth, and here are a group of people that are in the land. And what were they told to destroy? Their pictures. What kind of pictures? Pictures of idols. The archaeologist has dug up all of this today, and their molten images, and they're to destroy their high places. That was the place of pagan and heathen worship, and the vilest practices took place in these high places. It would be something that would correspond today to what's happening in this permissive society. It reveals a very low spiritual state, and that they were far from the living and true God. They were idolatrous. Now, added to that, they know today that these people in that land, the Canaanites, were absolutely eaten up with venereal disease. Now, today, we hear that there's more or less of an epidemic of venereal disease, and it is a plague, and it's a grave danger. It does great injury to the human race. Now, that land is right at the crossroads of the world. It's one of the most sensitive spots that there is. It's been that in our day. It always has been that. I think it always will be that. However, someday there'll be peace on the earth. But this land here is very strategic land, and the armies of the world have marched through there, and they had contact with peoples everywhere. Believe me, they were disseminating and scattering this loathsome diseases everywhere. Now, God is putting out a tenant who doesn't pay rent, and they're destroying his property, and they're hurting the rest of mankind. Now, don't come and tell me today, friends, God didn't have the right to do that, and for the sake of oncoming generations, what he did was actually an act of mercy. It was for the sake of the future. The same reason the flood came. God was thinking of the future. It's so easy to criticize today without realizing what all is involved.